Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to the second annual Keep Smiling for Abby fundraiser here in Hopkinton. Of course, we want to thank everybody for coming out. And what you're going to see today is game one is the community versus the parents of ex and current players from the field hockey team. Before we get started, though, we'd like you to remove your caps and please stand. There's going to be the singing of the national anthem by Amelia and Michael.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
A great round of applause, please, for those two singers. We just recruited them. We want everybody to know also that this both games and the event is being filmed by HCAM TV, your local cable TV channel. Go to their website, www.hcam.tv, if you want to see when it's going to be shown. All right, here's the starting. Here are the lineups for today's first game. Number one, for the parents' team, Patty Zeff. They're asking you to run out to the field. Number two, Mary Pelgrin. Number four, Anne-Marie Jeffress. Number five, Jody Dolan. Number six, Paul Flaxman. Number seven, Kathleen Karp. Number eight, Sue Kohler. Number nine, Carol Keefe. Number 10, Sherry Damari. Number 11, Kara Santola. Number 18, Amy Benford. Number 12, Becky Abate. Number 14, John Petruni. Number 15, Anne-Marie Sullivan. Number 16, Jerry Keefe. Number 19, Steve O'Loughlin. Number 20, the dapper Dave Puig. Number 21, Steve Benford. Number 22, Gary McWilliams. Number 23, Bob Machi. And we have a number 24, Dave Simone.
And then just Joan. Don't forget Joan.
And then finally, Joan Bannon. By the way, we want to mention there's a trainer here, Dana Cavadon. For those who might need it, Pat. All right, here's the community team. Actually, Joan's on this list also, so she's playing for both teams. Number two, Samantha Lee. Number three, Audra Curran. Number four, Michaela Benford. Number six, Megan Cuddy. Number seven, Stacy Place. Number eight, Aaron O'Neill. Number nine, Allie Jones. Number 10, Barbara Girardi. Number 11, Matt Curran. Number 12, Pam Thomas. Number 14, Peter Mazette. Number 15, James Cassidy. Number 16, Matt Sacklad. Number 18, Gene Birchman. Number 20, Scott Jurassic. Number 21, Brian Thomas. Number 22, Dave Benford. Number 23, Joe Diana. Number 24, Justin Pominville. Number 25, John Corridan. Number 26, Pat Mahan. Number 27, Josh Hanna. Number 28, Yeah, 28, Phil Powers. Number 29, Mike Flanagan. Number 30, Jay Guelphy. And number 32, Sue Cassanza.
Get them all.
This is going to be two 10-minute halves with oxygen permitted between halves.
All right.
And actually, Joan Bannon is going to be the referee for today's first game.
Can you close that window for you, Mike? I don't know.
Yeah, just a little bit.
You'll be listening to I'm Mike Prate with Mike Whalen. And again, this is being filmed for HCAM TV. Check their website and you'll find out what time the games are being played on the channel. We're using a little bit larger ball here, Mike. Temperature here is 81 degrees today, so we'll see how this plays out. Chasing it down. Matt Sacklad, a shot on goal. As the green team tries to clear it, but here's number four, Michaela Benford. Green trying to come the other way. The parents' team. And it's Paul Flaxman throwing it up the middle now. First half jitters, Mike?
Well, yeah, they're trying to find their groove out here tonight, this after. I think some of these players have probably never played field hockey ever before.
Uh, Here comes the parents team now trying to get up field. Dave Puig knocks the ball down. He's the one we'll definitely be able to see all game.
He's easy to spot, obviously.
Inside the circle. Ball's thrown towards the goal. There's a shot blockered by the goalie. Shot and a goal.
A goal. Not sure who got that. Who grabbed that ball and run up the field so we can tell who scored.
All right, they're saying Matt Sacklad scored the goal. UMass Amherst student, friend of the program we're running here today. That's the first goal. So the community on top of the parents, 1-0. And now the parents will put the ball in play. And here's the community team coming up again.
Yeah, they're looking for more. I don't think one goal is going to stand up today.
There's a launch shot towards the circle. And now that trying to keep.
So far, we've had a penalty-free game here. I guess everybody is obeying the rules. As you know, in some field hockey games, the whistle blows every 15 seconds.
At least according to the varsity coach that's out there on the field. And there's a whistle. 6 minutes to go in the first half. The parents.
And there's a shot that went towards goal.
Kick save, but that's not legal, right, Mike?
Right. No, we're going to have to reverse direction.
Should be legal.
Joan was all over that call.
Parents' team tries to throw it in towards the goal, but quickly it comes out. Dave Puig now controls the ball, throws it towards the middle. Now it's Jody Dolan. She launches towards the middle, too. It's in the circle now. A lot of stick action. You can hear it up here in the booth.
You know, I was thinking, Mike, with the demise of the Boston 2024 Olympics, this will probably be our best shot at seeing championship field hockey around in these parts.
That's a good point. I knocked out of the air, which I know was illegal, based on being told over and over again by you, Mike.
Yeah.
There's a swing and a miss.
Right. That was a tough.
And John Petruni. About 4 minutes and 45 seconds to go in the first half. The community team leading 1-0.
You know, except for that one goal, it seems to be a pretty much even match here. Nobody's really taken charge.
And there's subbing on the fly as we go here, just like a regular ice hockey game. Ball goes out of bounds. And it's going to be the community ball.
What kind of ball is it they're using anyway? Can you figure that out? What is some kind
one
of
that no one will get hurt getting hit by, it looks like.
It's like a mini soccer ball.
All right, it's inbounded. The green team putting some pressure on now. Flaxman trying to throw it up. And there is Carol Keefe tries to get it back. Pat Mahan uses
his feet.
I
don't know. That didn't look right. I don't know about that.
He better be careful. All right, it's a free. What do you call this, Mike?
It's a free hit. Sure.
All right, almost had it right.
Yeah.
I got to go to these games a little more. Joan always tells me I should. For the novice people here, what I found amazing is that You can only use one side of the stick, supposedly.
Right. Whoever invented this game was right-handed, and that's the way it's going to stay.
Yeah, you can't be left-handed. Oh, you can be, but... I had a little bit of jockeying back and forth. Another kick save there by somebody on the community team with a hat on backwards.
Plus, the as everyone will notice, the sticks aren't all that long.
Yeah, it's amazing. If you don't you don't follow the sport, there's flat on one side is a shot towards the goal. There's a loose puck. The goalie kicks it out to the middle now, right in front. And there's a whistle.
Nope, she's going the other way. Must have been a violation in the circle.
Yeah, one side of the stick is flat. The other side's rounded.
And you can only hit with the flat.
Which makes it a truly amazing game when you really think about it. All right, the community team launches it towards the goal. The goaltender kicks it out. There's a swing and a miss. A shot goes wide. Still battled around in front towards the goal, and it is
we got a score
in.
All right, who got that one?
It's waved off.
No, no.
The referee is waving the goal off.
Wow. I don't know what she saw.
Yeah, you know these referees. Oh, that's probably not legal, is it?
No, I don't know.
Stacy Place knocked it out of the air about 12 feet in the air. And there's a whistle. There's a minute and 15 seconds to go in the first half with the score Community 1 and the parents nothing. And the community on the attack again. Josh Hanna actually got a stick on the ball there once. Shot towards the middle, in front, still loose. Stacy now tries to throw it to the front, still in front of the goal. A few backhanded tries there. And out of the danger zone it comes, but right back towards the goal it goes. Thirty seconds to go in the first half. Up field, Pat Mahan comes over to get it, swings, and actually makes contact. We'll try to find that on the tape for you, Pat. And there, back to normal. Yeah, give him three tries. He's a baseball guy.
Okay. Time's expired, Mike.
And that'll do the first half. With the score, Community 1 and the parents nothing. As we'll take a little bit of break. Everybody water up. Make sure you're hydrated out there. There is a trainer, Dana Cavanaugh, if you need it. All right, we're getting ready for the second half where the score is the Community 1 and the Hiller parents nothing. Last year's event, of course, if you remember, it was about 15 degrees warmer. But we still wanted to remind you to keep hydrated here. Especially a certain guy with a green hat on out there, whose number is 26.
So I didn't put up a one yet, did I? Okay. Let's see. That would be the guest. Score plus one. Here we go. What's John's last name? John. John
Let's see. John Coop. Coop.
The referee talking things over with the Hopkinton photographer who seems to be everywhere with that camera. John Copley, everybody. They're trying to tell him to get off the field, but he won't. All right, we're ready for second half action. And the parents' team this time will serve it up. Swing and a miss. Jody now goes and gets it.
What?
Oh, she seems to be. Jones calling a little closer here to start the second half.
She must have got criticized.
Yeah, she let a few things go there the first half. No.
All right, the parents team launches it deep. And that was number 24, Dave Simone. It'll be the community ball as they lead 1-0. Swing and a miss. Oh,
hit it again. Hit it again. Hit it again.
Jody has it now, lifts it towards the middle, gets it back, goes towards the sideline. She jumps, tries to trip.
I think that was by accident. I think that
though.
Was a dive, Mike.
Was it?
Yeah, she's watching too much.
15-yard penalty?
She's watching the Montreal Canadiens, I think.
Hey, that sport I know, or I think I know. All right, so this is what's called a corner?
Yeah, close enough. Long hit, but from the corner.
They should have got somebody who knew this game to do this, although the price was right. Well, that ball's hit hard towards the middle, but it's defended nicely. And now out of the danger zone it comes.
I really didn't expect this game to be such a defensive battle. I thought it might be a high-scoring affair like a lot of All-Star games are. But
well, I heard that there was not a lot of practice. And here's a ball towards the middle, swing and an almost miss. It's still loose as shot. It's blocked down in front by four purple people. Hey, how about that, purple people? Bouncing ball is a shot that goes over the goal. So if there was 3 points allowed, that would be good.
Right, that's good.
Pat knew that. I saw him raise his hand. He said field goal. As a ball gets to midfield. One thing I always wondered about this, I bet you get hit in the ankles a lot here, huh?
Well, they have those pads that they wear.
Underneath the socks or something?
Yeah.
There's a launch ball. That is a whistle. And here comes the parents' team as they get it in. To the sideline it goes. Mike, it looks like the community team is just playing the stall tactic here.
Well, they might be. They're just sitting on the lead. They think they can hold on to it for the next 6 minutes and come away with a victory.
Oh, between the legs shot there. Tricky shot there by Justin Palmerville. No, check that. That's 24, Dave Simone. Right. And the green team trying to put pressure on to get it into the circle, but no avail. Now it's stolen away. John Petrucci stole it. Oh, Patty Zeff tried to get in there. Jody looking to set up somebody. Goes to the side. Beautiful pass to Zeff. Inside blocker towards the front. And it's a goal.
Score.
And the parents have tied it up. And getting the ball out of the goal, number two, Mary Pellegrin.
Well, that changes everything. That changes everything. Now with only 5 minutes left and a tie ball game.
You sit on that lead, Purple, and look what happened. Oh, by the way, this is a community fundraiser.
Oh, yeah, too, yeah.
In other words, a tie wouldn't be too bad, would it?
No, that would be okay, but still. I think people out there like to win, too.
And there's 4 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the ball game. We are tied at one. And now Purple looking to attack. Stolen away. Parents got their act together. Must have been a great halftime speech, Mike.
Well, maybe they're just in good shape, you know. Maybe they've been conditioning and pointing towards this day all summer.
Yeah, the weightlifting and running regiment that was preseason. There's a swing and a semi-miss, but it's taken away now. Green tries to throw it back in. Towards the sideline it goes. Good move. Pat Mahan just got faked out. He forgot to put his cleats on.
Pat might be the senior player on the field. I'm not really sure if he.
Yeah, he could be.
He could be.
Well, I'll give him credit. He's out there. We're standing in here where it's air conditioned.
Right.
Or semi air conditioned. The ball goes out of bounds. 3 minutes and 10 seconds to go in the hockey game.
Well, this is crunch time, but for sure. We'll see who's got what it takes.
You might have said to yourself before the game that 10 minutes and a half is not enough. I'm beginning to think it was enough. All right, thrown in, but back out. Does the community team. It's taken away. Looking to make one last rush. 2 minutes and 30 seconds to go.
I assume we're not having any kind of sudden death playoff here.
Yeah, we should have asked Jones. It's going to be a shootout.
If we finish tie.
It's 1-1.
Oh, yeah.
We are tied at one with 2 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the contest. Unless, of course, there's going to be a shootout, which might be kind of fun. Here comes Purple, though. They're looking to make a move. They do get it in. Swing and a miss. There's a ball towards the goal. It's kicked out. Now back out to the top of the circle, and it's relief has come. Kathleen Karp tried to throw it out. Now it's thrown out, but kept right back in. Now it's, nice block with the stick there by number three, Audra Curran. And there is a minute and 30 seconds to go. Purple putting some pressure on now. Green trying to get it over center field. 1 minute and 10 in the contest. Jody with it now. Taken away by Josh Hanna. Throws it up the sideline. Gets it back. That looked like his 8-iron that we've seen this year. Actually, that was a better shot than his 8-iron. Now taken away. 30 seconds to go. Throwing towards the middle. It's a ball that's knocked out of the circle and defended nicely. And pushed up the sideline. It's still in. Towards the middle. 14 seconds to go. Pat Mahan knocks it down.
Got the ball.
Oh, he made a great play there. Got to give him that. Kicked in front. Another kick.
Beautiful.
That's what are all probably legal,
it's a
huh?
good move.
No, it's not. The whistle's blown. And that's going to do the game. That'll do it. Let's have a great round of applause for this group of players. Can we get your attention for 1 second? Steve Benford's going to talk to the crowd, and we're going to turn it over to Steve right now. He's on the platform right by the track, so if you could just put your attention towards him. Thanks.
Hi, everyone. Thanks for coming out today. I'll be brief. We got to stay on schedule. Kim's driving me hard here to stay on schedule. So I just wanted to say a few thank yous. I want to thank Joan Bannon and Kim Puig for driving this event. They've embraced it as a program, and I want to thank them very much. I want to thank Gene Birchman. Gene organized about 40 volunteers to get us together here this morning. We threw the field together really quick. It came together great. Thank you to Gene Birchman. Mike Spector. Mike Spector had another singer with him. I can't remember her name.
Amelia.
I want to thank Mike and Amelia for singing. They performed before the event started. Provided a nice little backdrop for us, so thank you. Mike also was the 2015 Keep Smiling Award winner at Hopkinton High School, so congratulations to Mike. I want to thank our sponsors. We've had great sponsor support this year. You can check out the banner. Most of them are local businesses here to Hopkinton. If you need their services, please use them. They've been huge supporters for us. Most of them increased their support this year. So thank you to all of our sponsors. I want to thank the field hockey program in general. I thank Joan for helping the event, but I want to thank the field hockey program in general. The players, the parents, they've really embraced our cause. They've embraced our cause is important to them and owned it. And I want to thank the entire program, the alumni, the parents, the varsity teams, everybody associated with the program has been just great to our cause. They've really been a nice platform for us to gain credibility with our research partners. So thank you to the field hockey program. In particular, I want to thank the 2014 varsity team. Last year, they embraced Keep Smiling for Abby as their cause for the year. And each home game, they hosted and they passed out reminder bands to their opponents at the end of every game. And at the end of the season, when they're in the middle of a playoff run, they're trying to get a playoff berth, they hosted a Keep Smiling game at the other field down the street over here on the corner. It could have been a distraction. It wasn't. They made the playoffs. They donated over $2,000 to Keep Smiling for Abby from that one game. So huge, huge support. Thank you. I want to address the donor base. We've asked a lot from our donor base this year. We've increased our funding, our fundraising platforms. We've added an event. Samantha Lee just played in the game. I think she was number two. She raised over $7,000 for us by running the Boston Marathon. We've grown our two events. We did a Derby Day about 3 months ago, I guess, right? And we added the event. We did the Derby Day. We did this event, and it's a lot to ask in just a few short months. But the same donor base delivered each time. Our fundraising, just to sort of put a number on it for you, our fundraising is up over 25% year over year. We added an event. We're tapping the same people. We really appreciate your commitment to our cause. So thank you very, very much. So our goals, I just want to touch on our goals. There's many new faces here today. We have three goals. One is to fund research into early detection of anaphylaxis. As you may know, my daughter, David's sister, Amy's daughter, Abby, died from an anaphylactic reaction. Anaphylaxis is a big word, but what it really means is your system shutting down. You have to take emergency action very quickly. Our view is that there's a technology solution out there that can solve this problem. We just have to fund it and tie the right pieces together to deliver a life-saving technology to over 15 million Americans. 1 in 20 Americans is at risk of anaphylaxis. That's a big number. It rivals some of the most popularly funded, biggest funded programs and diseases. Anaphylaxis gets almost no attention. Our goal is to raise that level, fund it, and deliver a life-saving technology to 1 in 20 Americans. There's two kids in every classroom. These are big numbers, and I want to thank everybody here today for embracing that cause and giving us credibility with our donor, with our research partner. We're researching, we're working with the Wyss Institute at Harvard University. This is a real project. They've applied for NIH grants. $3.5 million grant went in. They're waiting to hear the outcome of that grant. There's real money, real technology, real scientists behind this, and I just want to thank you and remind you of that. Some fun. Where's Steph Puig? Stephanie, come on up here. So Stephanie gets the highest fundraiser award. There's a SoundLink Mini here. I remember Stephanie was one of Abby's closest field hockey friends. And I remember when I met Steph, Abby was impressed that she was enthralled with Steph. She couldn't believe that Steph had lived in London or England. I think it was London. And when I met Steph for the first time, I picked Steph up at her house for a field hockey summer practice, I think it was. Maybe it was early season practice. And Steph, Abby, all the way over to Steph's house, Abby said, "You can't believe it. She lived in London, Dad. She's incredible." And Steph gets in the car, and I said, "Steph, you live in London?" She goes, "Yeah." And it was no big deal. It was a really funny little contrast. It was awesome. So Steph raised over $500. I might have pushed 600 because she had some latecomers today. Single biggest fundraiser for the alumni and field hockey mix. Thank you very much, Steph. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, here's the lineups for both squads. For the alumni team first, they are in orange. Number one, Emma Flaxman. Number two, Ashley Simone. Number three, Katie Pelgrin. Number four, Lauren O'Loughlin. Number five, Carolyn Carey. Number six, Andrea Gendron. Number seven, Julie Eunice. Number eight, Kerry McBride. Number nine, Tiana Damari. Number 10, Dana Cavanaugh. Number 11, Sarah Kennedy. Number 12, Tam Mills. Number 13, Keelan Bannon. Number 14, Megan Fujioshi. Number 15, Kelly Fournier. Number 16, Brennan Lavoie. Number 17, Maddie Lyman. Number 18, Jessica Mullen. Number 19, Jacqueline Cherko. Number 20, Elizabeth Keefe. Number 21, Nicole Wigglesworth. Number 22, Carolyn Shea. Number 23, Katrina Parsons. Number 24, Megan Jeffress. Number 25, Meg Greff. Number 26, Holly Frank. Number 27, MC Nealon. Number 28, Mallory Bannon. Number 29, Eliza Carroll. Okay, here's the lineup for the Hopkinton varsity field hockey team. Number one, Allison Simone. Number two, Mackenzie Burke. Number three, Haley Zeff. Number four, Sarah Friedman. Number five, Maggie Dolan. Number six, Erin Keefe. Number seven, Jacqueline Barnes. Number eight, Delaney O'Brien. Number nine, Stephanie Puig. Number 10, Maddie Jeffress. Number 11, Natalie Santola. Number 12, Megan Kelly. Number 13, Kayla Sullivan. Number 14, Parker Petruni. Number 15, Chloe Smith. Number 17, Chloe Damari. Number 18, Katie Schneider. Number 19, Julia Mackey. Number 20, Alexandra Karp. Number 21, Elizabeth Kohler. And number 22, Elise Chandler. That is the varsity roster for today's game. Well, the referee, I guess, again, is Joan. And they're going to use a real size ball. It'll make it a little easier for you, Mike.
I bet it's going to be a good game. This is, I guess you'd call this a preseason game for the Hill of Varsity field hockey team. We'll see what kind of team we're going to have here coming up this year, 2015 season. I imagine everybody's kind of curious as how well they'll do.
Some of these players on the alumni team have either, of course, played at the college level or are attending college. So you're right. It should be an interesting game. We are going to play 20-minute halves of running time. And our referee, Joan Bannon, is ready to go.
Well, there's that. I see Steve's got the big trophy there on the sideline. It's going to be awarded to the winning team. You can see him over there by the bench. Pretty impressive looking piece of hardware there.
We just want to know what the goalie's name for the alumni team is, because we don't have a 52 on our roster. So, thank you. Once again, a reminder, this game is being filmed on HCAM television. Please go to their website, www.hcam.tv, and you can see the schedule on when this will be broadcast. It'll only be streamed online also. All right, we get ready to go here as the alumni has it first. And they are using the regulation size ball, of course.
Regulation size ball here, and on a grass field where the Hill is have been playing for many years on the grass.
The alumni team gets it over the line, but it's defended by the varsity, and there's a whistle. And so alumni has it. They launch it towards the circle. It's intercepted, shot towards the goal. And the varsity comes away with it. A little bit of stick battle there, Mike, inside.
Yeah, a little different than the ice hockey that you are a little more familiar with. As we spoke about in the first game there, where you're only using one side of the stick.
The alumni has it now. They launch it towards the middle of the field, but the varsity intercepts it now. And a good stick work there on the sideline by Tam Mills. Tam was a fire plug on that varsity squad when she played. Now here comes the alumni. They're coming in. Julie Eunice. It's intercepted by the varsity. So there's a shot. It's a sword play going on in the circle now. There's a shot towards the goal. And it is in the goal line, and it's a goal. Oh, no,
nope.
It's waved off. It went right on the goal line, no goal.
No, so that.
That ball looked like it was right on the white line.
This is called a 16-yard hit now, so that ball obviously went over the end line.
Varsity trying to put pressure on. Intercepted by Megan Jeffress. Now it's taken away. And back to help out is Dana Cavanaugh, but it's taken by the Varsity's Aaron Keefe. Shot towards the goal. It's kicked out. Turnaround shot. It's still Jacqueline Cherko in goal. She made a stop initially and got on the post and stopped it again.
Over the end line, so coming back out.
Just about 16 minutes to go in the first half. There's no score. The alumni pushing the pace here a little bit. That's taken away by the Varsity squad. Taken right back by the alumni, though, number two.
It's a good
Ashley Simone.
Obviously, a good turnout from the alumni. They almost have a full team on the sidelines. They could substitute and get fresh legs easily.
I think there's 14 on the sideline. All right, the Varsity trying to get it towards the middle. Now they do. They throw it in. There's a shot towards the goal, kicked out by Cherko. And now it's run out of the circle and launched up. Field. It's a great event you're watching here, of course, both here in the stands and on television. It's,
you know, this is a good test for both teams to see where they stand. I'm sure the alumni would love to beat the current team, and the high school team would feel pretty good about measuring up against these alumni.
Yeah, this is a group of new players for the Varsity, right? They'll be starting up
as soon as they let them.
Right.
Whatever that is.
Yeah.
Middle of August or something.
A little bit of side work going on over there. Maddie Jeffress hits it. Several of the alumni players, Mike Wright, played at the next level.
Yeah, quite a few, actually. It's no secret. Joan's got a pretty good program going here.
A little bit of a battle right there with Megan. And it's taken away. Just under 14 minutes to go in the first half. There's no score. You're watching the Varsity versus the alumni. The second annual Keep Smiling for program. Tam Mills, looks like. Nope, check that. It's number 20. Elizabeth Keefe. I know her as Liz Keefe.
That's Liz Keefe, yeah. She's one of the many veterans from the state championship team from, I don't know, maybe 5 years ago.
Nice play by Allison Simone. Towards the circle it goes. Number 8, Carrie McBride, throws it out of the Zone there. Well, intercepted. Katie Schneider battling for the varsity. Not sure if the grass cut at the right height, Mike.
Well, you know, I think the for field hockey, the lower the better. It's probably the way to go.
Yeah, it looks kind of thick still, though, right?
Yeah. But this is a field that's really dedicated to football anyway, as you know.
Well, there's only going to be three games on this field this year on their schedule. So.
Right, yeah. So.
All right, the whistle is blown. 11 minutes and 30 seconds to go in the first half. Varsity versus the alumni, field hockey. Settle down now. There's a whistle. Mallory Bannon. Knocked down. The varsity enters the circle. No, you make the call there, Mike. You know the rules.
You know, I don't know. You know, sometimes I wonder, I scratch my head at other officials' calls. You know?
The less call, the better, Mike, right?
You know, the very first game I officiated, I don't think I blew the whistle once. And the coach came up to me after the game and said, "Thanks for letting them play." So I took that and ran with it.
Yeah, right. 10 minutes to go in the first half. Not a lot of offensive action, but give Joan credit. She's running back and forth.
Well, you know, Joan obviously at this point has coached everybody out on the field. There's nobody there that didn't learn field hockey from her.
And the varsity enters now, looking to set up, but it's taken away. -81 degree temperature. It's nice compared to last year.
It was really hot last year.
Last year was like a 93 or so. At game
I think we
time.
Even had a break in the action for water or something last year.
Well, I just remember them, I think, coming up saying to us, "All right, cut the game down."
Right. So this is our first penalty corner for the game, the chance for the Hopkinton.
Well, it was defended nicely by the alumni score. Team. Not taken back though. A little bit of a scrum out front. Alumni trying to push the pace here. Now they launched it up, but it's defended nicely by Chloe Damari.
Well, I got to say at this point here, I'm even more so impressed with the Hiller high school team. They look pretty good. I predict a good year.
I predict a good year. right, the alumni get the ball. They launch it. That's defended by the varsity team on the sideline. Goes out of bounds. The alumni now has the ball. They throw it to the middle. Nice pass. But it's defended nicely. By number one, Allison Simone. She got right in front of that pass attempt. Now she takes it away. Jessica Mullen threw it in. She comes to get it. Parker Petruni now with the ball. Right back to Simone. She has it, makes a move. Petruni throws it towards, but it's defended. Another nice launched ball.
There's a lot of running involved in this game here. It seems like you just start running when the time stops, and you don't stop until the buzzer rings.
You got to be in pretty good shape to play this.
Oh, yeah.
Six minutes to go in the first half. There's no score. And the viewers at home are watching HCAM's coverage of the second annual varsity versus alumni field hockey game with a fundraising benefit for Keep Smiling for Abby. You folks at home can go to the website, keepsmilingforabby.org.
A lot of sports on HCAM, I've noticed. A lot of stuff.
HCAM's news is here also. And there'll be coverage on the website also. The alumni gets it in the circle now. They make a pass. It's knocked down in front. And right back out. Farsi tries to get out of danger. Good play by Chloe Damari. There's a whistle. 4:30 to go. First half. Good play by the varsity program. Players, rather. Launched in the middle of the circle. The pass. And there's a whistle.
All right. Now we've got, I think she called a penalty inside the circle, so that's going to set up this next play.
This is commonly called a corner, right?
That's correct. Yeah,
I remember that. So, oh, good play.
Pretty good defense there by the Curran Hillers.
Yeah, that. Players on the far side. I can't identify the number. Number six. It's Aaron Keefe. 2 minutes, 50 seconds to go in the first half. There's no score. Mike pointed out that the alumni has about 14 players on their bench where the
varsity squad.
They're probably going to come out strong in the second half here with wholesale substitution.
Varsity squad has 8. Couple of sister combinations here, you know.
There's a few
on the varsity versus alumni game. That's always fun, right? Play against your sister.
Sure. Sister against sister, brother against brother. We've all been there.
That's for sure. Varsity makes a nice play. That's taken back. Shot. It's Andrea Gendron, number 6. Now there's a whistle. Taking the shot, Keelan Bannon. Launches it towards the goal, and it goes out of bounds. 1 minute, 25 seconds to go. That's a dangerous swing,
yeah,
right?
They frown on that.
It's a chip shot. A minute to go in the first half. Dana Cavadon with the ball. And there's a whistle. Keelan Bannon, back to Cavadon. Ten seconds to go in the half.
Well, we're gonna have to have a goal in the second half here because we're not gonna.
And that's halftime.
That's it.
So at the half, there's no score. We are gonna take a 5-minute break. And we will resume second half action in a moment. All right, we're getting ready for the second half where there's no score between the current varsity squad for Hopkinton and the former varsity squads.
Well, we need a winner here because this trophy has to go somewhere, so we need a winner. So,
in the event of a tie, what happens in the event of a tie in one of these real games?
What is the tiebreaker formula? I'm not sure.
What is it in a real? Are they just tie? Are they tie?
Well, they tie. And
what about in playoffs?
Yeah, we have to come up with some type of formula. Or even flip a coin to something.
All right. The alumni team seems to be going the same way.
Right.
Not to confuse people, especially the two up here in the booth.
Yeah.
Fans, we'd like to remind you again, of course, this is being filmed by HCAM TV, which is your local cable television station. They have a website, hcam.tv, and please go to it. I'm sure this will be broadcast a couple of times. All right, the varsity got a talking to by their coach. And the alumni now, the second shift in there, Mike.
A combination.
Oh, that looked like a check.
You know, the field hockey rules do seem to be become, you know, they get amended every year or tweaked every year. They ever evolving and changing.
Yeah, I got to film the, or you were with me actually. We filmed the state championship game.
Well, yeah, that was 5 years ago, maybe or so.
And it's amazing the game has the speed when it's on artificial turf, right?
It's hard to. It's like on a pool table.
Yeah. And the alumni now trying to get it in the Hiller territory. Nice stick work there. Ball's thrown in the circle on the ground in front. Hiller's try to defend it out, and they do get it somewhat out. A couple of the alumni players are encouraging, yelling at the bench. Boy, that was...
It's over the end line, so that's coming the other way.
We just started.
Goalies really haven't had many save opportunities here.
I'm not sure there has been any, right? Except, let's mention those goaltenders who are wearing the stuff. Sarah Friedman in the goal for the varsity team, and Jacqueline Churko, I think, is still in goal for. Nope, it's Lauren O'Loughlin, someone yelled up to me. Thank you. The coaches didn't send up the game plan to us here. Seventeen minutes to go in the second half. There's no score. Well, this is a hard shot towards the middle, and it goes out of bounds. And it's going to be a corner, right? No. Yep.
I think that's what you call. Okay, right. It's always the best opportunity to score on plays like this.
Yeah, the defenders. The other defenders can't come in until the ball is touched.
Right, they're 50 yards away.
And a good defensive play by the Hillers. Turn in front. Now a shot that goes towards the goal, but it's knocked down. Good defensive play in front. Pass in front. There's a shot and a goal.
We have a goal.
The alumni have scored. And who is picking the ball up?
I don't know. Who scored that goal? Raise your hand, wave.
Now I see the person. She's just got to turn around. Sarah Kennedy with the goal. No? Oh, Liz.
Liz Keefe?
Liz, turn around so we can see your number. Thank you. Liz Keefe. So we have a score, 1-0 at the 14:50 mark or so. It's a scramble in front and a looked like a nice jam shot on goal, right?
Liz has scored a few goals in her time. That wasn't her first one.
Varsity trying to mount the push up the
well, in this game, you know, one goal is a lot.
There they varsity now throws it towards the goal, kicked out by the goaltender. Good defensive play. Varsity making a charge now. We want to remind folks, though, that at 3:30, the raffle's going to close. So if you're trying to do something, please get there. Cleared out by the alumni. There's a shot towards the goal. The alumni trying to get it out. We've had to adjust the time clock because we are getting some reports that there's some thunder clouds coming. So we're going to have 6 minutes to go in the game.
No pressure.
Alumni winning 1-0. The shot, oh, in front. Ball just eluded. The alumni having problems getting it out. There's 5 minutes to go in the game. Nice defensive play by number 13, Kayla Sullivan.
You know, with Joan being the official, I wonder where her loyalties lie in this game here.
Well, it's out of bounds.
Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Here's the visited in the booth here by the star of the first game, Pat Mahan.
He didn't hurt anybody, he didn't hurt himself.
All right, 4 minutes and 25 seconds to go in the game. Punch towards the sideline now. The alumni trying to get over it.
So, Pat, did you play field hockey in high school? Were you one of those, boys that played on the girls' team? Or?
I wore a dress in high school, but that was about it.
That's something we probably don't want to talk about.
It's that Catholic school upbringing.
The varsity trying to get some momentum here. 3 minutes and 50 seconds to go. The alumni leading 1-0. Intercepted. Allison Simone. Now it's launched over the midfield stripe. Now the alumni team's pretty talented too, though, Mike, huh? They've still got some skill.
Yeah, well, you know, they're not that far removed. I mean, it's not like when we say alumni, we're talking about recent alumni.
People who can still run, you mean?
Right.
Just under 3 minutes to go. The alumni now trying to add one more. They lead 1-0. Varsity trying to come up the sideline. They launch it towards the middle of the field. They got a player there. Good play by Katie Schneider for the varsity. And the ball's out of bounds. 1 minute and 50 seconds to go in the game. One more push with a minute and 30. Out of bounds. Alumni ball. One minute to go in the game. Eliza Carroll with the ball. Forty-one. Now all the teams are coming on. Both teams have emptied their benches.
Right, I don't blame them. Yeah.
You know, Mike.
Yeah. Do we have too many on the field here?
Yeah, the referee's right on the ball there. 15 seconds to go in the game. And that does it. Game over. The alumni winning it by the score of 1-0. Both squads deserve a big round of applause here in our second annual game. And the alumni trophy, the trophy is going to be awarded to the alumni team. All right, Steve and Amy are going to give the trophy. Thing looks bigger than the Stanley Cup. And the trophy this year is going to go to the alumni squad. Okay, well, that's going to wrap up HCAM's coverage of this event. We want to thank again everybody else for coming out. For Mike Whalen, I'm Mike Prate with David Antacki on our camera. Thanks for watching, everybody.